Okay, regarding the eighth cranial nerve examination, the vestibulocochlear nerve, really we will, because of the of this cranial nerve consists of two components, so we will check the hearing ability of the patient and the balance ability of the patient, the cochlear part and the vestibular part respectively. First of all, really roughly during the clinical examination, if you would like to check the patient ability to hear, either to whistle a sound in the patient's ear or to rub your fingers. هسه تصم لنا عيونك حماده. شنو سوينا هسه احنا؟
صوت.
شبيه؟ اوكي عشت ايدك. هسه راح اصم هاي اذانك. هسه شنو؟ اوكي. This is just a rough assessment, rubbing test, just a rough assessment. And the best, افتح لنا عينك عشت ايدك. And the best assessment via the Weber test and the Rani test, really, which both of them are not part of the routine examination. After that, I'll check the vestibular components of the nerve via what we call it the Dix-Hellbike test. Really, the Dix-Hellbike test is also not a routine test, but sometimes it is inquired from the candidate. I'll perform it just like this. First of all, I'll make the patient in the middle. هسه تقدر تبقى هيك بس ظهرك عليا. يعني تقدر تمد رجليك ما في مشكلة، قاعد تتقدم لقدام، تبقى اوكي عشت ايدك. اوكي، first of all I'll grasp the patient's head. I'll lower it down على راحتك على راحتك. I'll lower it down up to 30 degree below the horizon and make the eyes bow at it, bow at it toward me. The lower part of his head is the right ear, and I'll wait for 20 to 30 seconds to see an nystagmus, which if occur, that is due to benign positional vertigo, last also just few seconds and then became fatigued. After that, I'll return back the patient and I'll perform it on the other side. Also, I'll wait for 20 to 30 seconds. Okay, after that, I'll make the patient sit. This test is really designated to check whether nystagmus can be elicited or not. If it is fatigable, if had a latency, and just a few periods, most likely cause is benign positional vertigo, while if it is non-fatigable and persistent more than this time, one should think about other causes like brainstem or cerebellum. This is really in brief the examination of the vestibulocochlear nerve.